Right, hello everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Final Fantasy 16, continuing right where we left off. And I also completely neglected to mention it last time, but, okay, that's some fake ambience that I hear because it's in my left ear no matter where I turn the camera. Essentially my one and only faithful Final Fantasy 16 viewer gifted me a key to Final Fantasy VII Remake Intrigue a couple days ago. I meant to mention that in the last episode, but completely forgot until now. And that was awesome, not just because I'm really interested in playing that game, but because it is of the four Final Fantasy games on Steam that I am yet to own. Well, that's now three games that I'm yet to own. It was the most expensive one, and money is something very difficult for me right now, so that saved my ass big time. So that is something that I can look forward to playing at some point in the future. How am I gonna weed my way through these? I'm not sure, like, what I'm doing next as far as Final Fantasy. Well, what I should do next for Final Fantasy is finish Final Fantasy 3, because that's an LP I already started. I just haven't started uploading it yet. And, most of the old Final Fantasy games, like Final Fantasy 1 and 2 that I played, were not very long. They were certainly not, you know, 80 plus hours like this LP is. They were around the 20 plus hour mark, give or take.
This place has been flooded twice over.
So I'm not sure if, like, Final Fantasy VII Remake will be...
Flowers blooming next to a waterfall. Shouldn't be too hard to find.
...will be the next immediate Final Fantasy Let's Play or one of the upcoming ones. I was kind of interested in doing a Let's Play of the original Final Fantasy VII before doing a Final Fantasy VII Remake thing, but that can, of course, change at any moment. Just like this LP, where I already cheated and skipped to number 16 instead of going in full order first. Just because I couldn't wait. Oh, okay. I guess he's gonna... What? Have they always done that? Have they always done the fly-at-you attack without first doing the shot of air? I don't know. Actually, you know what? This might be kind of dumb, but I have two hunts to do here, and I think one of them's an S rank, so I'm gonna save my juice. Just gotta remember, I can't really do many of my abilities. Oh shit, I didn't... Yeah, I forgot to do the Garuda thing. I did not get a refill of potions. That might be the end of me. Oh, see, now he's doing it. Did he do that before and I just avoided it on accident and didn't realize? I don't know. Okay, this is it. Oh, he's dead. Just make sure he's dead. These look like the things we're looking for. Right, not these ones. It has to be the ones on the other side of the river. Or creek, or whatever.
Here they are. Might as well pick enough for a bunch, I suppose.
Well, okay, that was easy. So, right. Well, we know we need to go here at the very least, and then we have to keep an eye out for another hunt somewhere in the open field. Of which there's a lot of open fields here. It's not that eyeball, because we fought that before. Oh, I think we found it. Okay. Is that the S rank? Because that's another behemoth. That's a yellow behemoth. So we fought a like a I don't know what. It's hard to determine the color of a behemoth. The first one we fought in the story was like a dark bluish gray. I don't know. It's like a gray. It's almost a black, but it's not fully black. It's like a purplish gray almost, I think, is what a behemoth is colored like. And then we fought a blue one in the Colosseum, which I want to bet is a direct callback to the behemoth you fight in Final Fantasy II, which you fight in a Colosseum, and it's blue. And now a yellow one. I have no idea what this is referencing, if anything at all. I don't remember a yellow behemoth in any of the games I've played. Well, that is still no doubt what we are supposed to hunt for, and I'm not really sure I like this. Because he's got more horns than the other ones had. He's big. He's huge. Well, I remember we fought these guys twice, so I kind of remember his attacks. Yeah, this is a hunt. Okay. So what do we have here? Ugh. He's green. Oh, he's electricity. Behemoth King, also known as King Behemoth. That's all right. Rank S. Well, I'm fucked. Okay. What? Oh, I see. Okay. Now, I want them to stop talking, thank you. Alright, this is gonna be tough. I'm just gonna whittle him down. That's what we're doing. We're going to play this safe. Not try to do any abilities while he's got... Ow. Okay, he didn't almost kill me, which is good. No. Okay, this is the thing where it's going to be... Yeah. Okay, I didn't time that right. What is this? I avoided that, I guess, but... Okay, I'm going to use Diamond Dust in just a moment. I'm trying to get him down to halfway on our own here. I also can't seem to pull off a Permafrost either, which sucks. Watch out! Oh, fuck. That's fine. I'm still alive. Oh, that's not good. I fucking hate that. Ow. If there is one thing I don't like about the combat against big enemies, it is that it targets the head. I guess I could just do this. I could turn off the lock-on. Maybe that would fix my issue. Because when it targets only the head, I miss a lot of my attacks when I could just hit his body or his legs, you know? Come on. Okay, bring him down. Come on, big boy, you know you want to get some sleep. Okay, now I'm going to pull a Diamond Dust out. I don't know if this will be enough to break his will. It did. Okay, we're going to just do as much as possible here. This is going to bring him down to 50%, you know what that means. But we still have lots of heals. Oh, we did a fuckload of damage. Okay, four horsemen. Yeah, we know about this. That ain't nothing. Okay, now he's doing Maelstrom as well, so... That's the tornado that tries to nab us. We got electricity, we got meteors. We got everything. So we did get a King Behemoth in this game. Yeah, I love King Behemoth in Final Fantasy X, because he's one of the scariest normal... What the fuck is this? Okay. What the hell? Okay, no. Stay, I see. I think I just like King Behemoth in Final Fantasy X because he's like whitish blue color and I'm biased towards blue. I hate this game. Okay. Really wish I could permafrost this guy. Not enough to bring Garuda in. Oh, I did, just barely. Why am I being pinged? Leave me alone. I'm trying to save the world right now, and by save the world, I mean I'm not. I'm just out fighting monsters. Oh, shit. Yeah, this is insane. But not too bad. It's all manageable. Two of them? All right. Three? No. What is this? Get away from it. That's what this is. Jesus. I like how that one didn't make a shockwave, but the little ones do. All right. I don't know if this is going to be enough. But it should get him close. Okay, that wasn't bad at all. Dang. And that was the S rank one. No reason for me to be worried about the next hunt. And we got some more cum and another behemoth shackle.
No match for you, Itogle.
Oh, and then he just disappears. Oh, man. Behemoth's a cool Final Fantasy creature. I've obviously already stated that my favorite is a curl, but Behemoth is one of the more badass ones. Because it's usually a late-game creature. And it's usually, you know, a tough son of a bitch. But as I explained, I think I said this when we fought him in the story, they made the Behemoth in the later games compared to the early games that I've played, like Final Fantasy II's Behemoth is a total pushover. It doesn't do half the shit it does in the later games. And I guess just back then when they were making Final Fantasy, they were like, hey, let's make a giant lion-like creature that casts magic. You know, cool thing, call it Behemoth because it's big, right? They didn't actually give it the ability to tear the planet into two pieces if it wanted to. Okay, and the other hunt is right here? Really? Two hunts right next to each other? Now my fingers are kind of cramped, but I can deal with an A rank. I did say that this place had like a... There's nothing here yet. Never mind. What the hell? I haven't seen one of these things in a while. Can't see. Watch out. I don't know what's happening. We fought these things before, but this one probably has some new moves. Oh, this is bad. I'm standing right on one of her attacks. Unless I cancel it. Should be nice. Ow. Nice. Pulled it off this time. Nope. Now, I'm not going to use my stuff right now. Just going to keep whittling her down a little bit, and then we'll use Diamond Dust when that refreshes to help us out. I want to get my limit break back up. If I even get the chance to, I don't know. Basically down to 50%. Watch out, ow, you bitch fucker. Ow. Ow. See, this one I'm not gonna get to pull down. Oh, never mind, I did. Get her nice and close. This one ain't bad at all. We just fought a king behemoth, or I'm sorry, behemoth king. This alien to me. This should be an easy finish off. What's her name? Giza Maluk? I don't know what that means. Probably some ancient mythological creature or something, or deity, who knows. Oh my god! I just got an achievement that says clear the hunt board. We just did all of the hunts, and I didn't even save the S rank for last. Clouded Eye. We've had those before, I think. Okay, well, I can put away my hunt paper then. Damn, we really are at the end of the game, aren't we? Starting to finish off all the shit. We built a legendary weapon. We've cleared all the hunts. I'm sure we're about to finish off our reputation. I'm sure that's the last rep reward, actually, in that list. We're done in Walud, so we can ship off. Now, I'm not going to go back to the hideaway just yet. Let's go to Martha's Rest. Save the hideaway for when, again, I get a bunch of stuff that I can turn in. Wow, that loaded fast. That wasn't supposed to happen.
Let's hope one of the merchants here has what Gav needs. Excuse me. I'm looking for something.
Oh, well, then I'm your man.
A silver chocobo feather.
Chocobo.
Oh, or maybe not. Though you're not the first to mention the bird around here. There was a man stopped by the rest not long ago, claiming he was attacked by a silver chocobo near some guide hovel not far from Eastpool. Most took him for a braggart and a liar, but who knows? Perhaps there was some truth to his tale.
We'll see. Thank you.
The feller who claimed he was attacked didn't linger here long. Said he was gonna go back and capture it. Prove us all wrong. And that was the last we ever heard of him.
It's a freaking bird, man. I killed a rainbow bird before. Oh, I have to speak with other merchants. I don't have to go to Eastpool right now.
We've got a few rooms going spare now. You want a bed for the night? You speak to Martha.
Hello.
Anything catch your eye?
Anything catch your eye?
Here we go, make a little bit more gill for me. Masamune. I would like to see, what are you selling for musics? Nothing. Oh, yes, you are.
There you go.
Higgins Mound, Bastion, and Bow.
Thanks
very
much. Much obliged.
There we go, we got plenty of gill now.
Just because the heavens have gone to wreck and ruin, it don't mean we have to. Now, let's get this stall set.
How do, traveler? You've the look of a man who could do with a new whetstone. Or perhaps a bawdy etching of the Viserine.
Maybe another time. I'm looking for a silver chocobo feather.
If that's the case, rumors are all you're likely to find. No one has seen a silver chocobo for years. Word is they were all hunted for their feathers. Some northern nonsense about bringing good luck. Didn't bring them much, nor their bows. If any are still out there, I reckon they'll be doing their damnedest not to be discovered.
You're probably right. Thank you anyway.
The hills around the rest are crawling with wild chocobos. If you're not too picky about the color of their plumes.
Well, I have to be kind of picky, so. Where the hell's the last one? I have to talk to three.
The world seems to be changing so fast lately I can hardly keep up. But what I do know is that there's more bad news than good. You can tell that just by looking at people's faces.
I need another taco ball. I guess it's anywhere in this place. Could be around this way, maybe? Hello?
I'll build a barricade so sturdy, even a bandit goes on.
Can I help you with summer?
You wouldn't happen to sell silver chocobo feathers, would you?
I deal in fruit, not fancies. But if it's fancies you're after, I suggest you try Rhiannon's ride.
Who?
Was a silver chocobo seen there?
Oh, yes. If you believe the ravings of a madman.
It wouldn't be the first time. Silver chocobo sighted in the hills near Rhiannon's ride. It sounds almost too good to be true. But since I'm already here...
Every few years, someone comes along claiming they've sighted a silver bow, but the truth of the matter is, there ain't no such thing. You'll find nothing but bloodflies and bandits on Rhiannon's ride. Mark my words.
You can't say there's no such thing if, you know, there was silver chocobos at one point. Even if they're believed to have gone extinct. Which, I mean, they haven't necessarily said that. I'm just saying. You could argue that if they did go extinct, there might still be some out there. Who knows? I don't really need to fight these guys. Excuse me. Fallen bug. Where are we going? Okay, off towards that building that's out there.
Bandits for a change.
Oh, those are chicken feet. What the fuck? Don't tell me there's a hunt here. I just finished hunts.
More tracks. And these look fresh. The chocobo was here. And recently... Perhaps it still is.
Oh shoot, I should have bought some potions while I was at the merchant. Well, whatever. We'll be going back to the hideaway at some point. And we have to go to Dalamil as well. And that place has a merchant.
I don't hear anything.
Oh, well, look at this. Isn't that just convenient?
Well, I'll be damned.
That's a very tiny feather. Oh, maybe not. I guess it is pretty big. Hello? Oh, there's multiple. They look exactly like Ambrosia.
It's all right. I'm not going to hurt you. Just borrowing a feather for my friend.
All right. Goodbye, me lord.
Thank you.
You're welcome, me lord.
Let's get this back together before they change their minds.
Yeah, because I'm sure they're going to chase us down. Okay, so that's that. It still doesn't explain what the fuck's going on down here. But whatever. Well, now that means we have to go to the desert. Because we've got loads of old shite in the desert. Two more quests as well. Let's see. Let's go. Bocklad has... Right, we need to go south to... the edge of Rondala. Ouchie. And there's a man here to sell me shit.
Well met.
Alright, I already bought your stuff. Whoops.
You've a discerning eye.
Do you have anything more to say? I don't know if... Like, is there new stuff?
What brings you to the caravans today?
Oh, fuck. What the hell?
When we fled our childhood home. I loved him. Did I tell you? That was what he wanted. No matter how hard it might be.
Well, gee, I'm sorry I'm doing all these side quests and the world is slowly falling apart, well, you know, because I'm not getting to the ending shit. To stop the end of the world. I think one might say the Dominion has risen, actually.
The Crimson Caravans must set an example. It is our job to keep the hope alive. Come back soon, won't you?
Well, I don't know. I'm back now.
Do you see that too?
Damn, I didn't even think to look, like when we were in Rosaria. I didn't even think to look for the big giant cocoon thing.
There are many variations of the Samekian legend, but almost all agree that man was punished for presuming to set foot in the sanctum of the gods. Some describe it as holy, others heavenly, which is to say, of the heavens. Could it be that the baleful mass that now glowers over us is this very sanctum? Have the gods returned to pass judgment upon us once more?
Even the chocobos are looking up at it.
It can't be. I'm seeing things.
No, you are not seeing things, my friend. You are... Well, I mean, you are seeing things, but... It's not an illusion. It's not a... Mirage.
Papa? What keeps it in the air? Why doesn't it fall?
Don't you go tempting fate, girl.
What is it?
Don't ask me.
Oh, please. Just make it stop. Make it stop.
Scared.
It's all right. I'm here.
Nothing good's gonna come of this, I'm telling you.
Just looking at it's enough to send a shiver down your spine.
Off we go. I don't see the city on fire. Not saying much, though. Leave me alone. My back itches. Oh, I don't have to... What? I don't have to hold the analog stick forward in order to actually run that way? No, I'm just... I'm literally just holding the R2 button right now. I guess I still have to use it to turn, but... What do we have out here? Bunch of old...
It can't be Rutherford, can it?
What do you mean, can't be? I see a bunch of people.
Turncoats and
cowards! Oh god, it's this guy. You.
If it's a fight you want, it's a fight you shall have!
Allow me.
I don't need your...
Please, Field Marshal,
Oblige. This won't take long.
What? We literally need to just come in here and start slaughtering people?
You're right. It won't.
Oh, okay.
Then finish him.
Yeah, alright. You guys worship Titan, right? How about some of this? I targeted the guy off to the right. I don't really appreciate it. Right. In memory of the Shiva versus Titan battle at the beginning of the game.
A little longer than I'd have liked. Field Marshal Havel, I presume. Are either of you injured?
No, my lord. You arrived just as our escort turned on us.
Oh, that was the escort.
Traitors. I'd heard reports of soldiers in the outlying regions abandoning the oaths they swore. But I hadn't thought the corruption had reached so close to the heart of the Republic. It's a fucking disgrace.
Fucking.
Your interfering old bastard of an uncle tried to warn me, of course. My lord, Marquis. Or is Sid the Outlaw more to your liking?
Call me what you want. It doesn't change who I am. Or the urgency of the message I bring. My uncle has a plan to right the realm, and he needs your help to see it through.
Before I agree to anything, I'd have you answer one question. What do you stand to gain from all this?
I don't know, freedom? For everyone?
I won't deny that I might benefit from further chaos. But I seek a new beginning for all of us. And while the choices I've made may not always have been the right ones, I know I made them for the right reasons. For so long, so many of us have been told how we could live, how we could die, when it should have been our decision all along. Now we have a chance to put things right. But in order to take it, we must stand together. Even if it be beside those with whom we don't see eye to eye.
Certainly not the words I expected from an outlaw. But perhaps your uncle was right. You are no ordinary outlaw. I'll never hear the end of this. All right. I'll start by ordering my most trusted guard to bring the Dalmechian fringes under control. Next, I'll make contact with my counterparts in the Imperial Army and see if I can't convince them to try and restore order in their own territory.
What Imperial Army?
Thank you, Field Marshal.
How much of that is left?
They are not the only ones we will need to convince.
What do you mean?
I don't doubt that I can bully some sense into a few generals. But those they answer to require a different kind of persuasion. And when it comes to honeyed words, we will need an envoy. One who can court even the most stubborn of statesmen. You, perhaps.
I'm flattered. But I'm no diplomat either. And I have other problems to attend to. What we need is a skilled arbitrator. And I may know just the person.
Is that so? And would he happen to be an outlaw too?
Of a different kind, perhaps.
Well, beggars can't be choosers. I suppose we'll all have to find a little of the outlaw in ourselves if we're to make it through this. Very well. Send your man to me right away.
I shall.
My lord Marquis, your lord uncle bade me escort the field marshal to his manor in Port Isolde.
And I will see that my associate joins you there.
Very good, my lord.
Very good, my lord.
Yes, me lord. Oh, jeez.
An envoy. I'm not sure I'm the man to talk anyone round. I can barely convince my brother to take his medicine.
You say it with your brother standing there.
This is a job for someone with experience.
Who? Like, I'm supposed to
someone
know?
Someone like Quentin. I hope I can convince him at least.
Quentin? That old shit from, like, 10 years ago? Oh, no, don't make me go back to Sam Breck. Ah, screw you. Okay, well, shoot. I guess we'll go here, because there's two things I've got to do. Alright, first of all, hello there. Would you sell me something? You've already been sold out.
The bearer of the burning quill is within, my lord. Privy Emperor.
Hello.
Your grace, my lord. I trust your journey was not overly onerous.
Cyril, you found a letter from father.
Yes, I have it here. If you would do us the honor, my lord.
Don't make me read out loud. My beloved sons, I know that I ask much of you in this coming war, but I see no other way to secure a future for our duchy and our family. Yet even should we succeed in subduing the savages and winning back Drake's breath, the threat of the Blight still looms, and only with all Rosaria striving as one might we at last overcome it. I have made plans to see us through, but such are the obstacles that stand in our way. It shall likely fall to you to continue my work. I know that you have the strength, the courage, and the will to do so. This shall be an arduous inheritance, and so I offer you another, that you might be reminded of the love and the faith that I hold for you both of you. Your father, Mr. Man.
An inheritance.
It would seem the late Archduke penned this missive shortly before his passing.
The day before we left for Phoenix Gate.
What are these plans he spoke of? His plans for the duchy, Your Grace. Your father entrusted them to my predecessor, the former bearer of the Burning Quill, who entrusted them in turn to me. The complete emancipation of bearers is their stated aim. But your father's dream did not end there. His Grace also spoke of building hospices to care for those stricken by the curse, and the founding of a new university to further the development of non-magical technologies.
Machina.
With the Blight spreading ever more widely across the Twins, Archduke Elwyn saw this as the only means of securing Rosaria's survival.
He wished to see men and bearers treated as equals. To see centuries of common wisdom overturned. Small wonder he did not think it achievable within his lifetime.
But he thought it achievable nonetheless. Had he not, he would never have written this message. Nor would he have entrusted his vision to his most faithful aides. Those who would have stood with you, shielded you from the machinations of the less benevolent personages at court.
It's a pity only they are still with us.
It is true that those most loyal to your father were the first to suffer the Duchess's wrath. But one at least remains. And she has come bearing gifts.
What do you mean?
Mayhap it is better that she explain, my lord. After all, the duties entrusted to me by my predecessor extended only to recovering His Grace's will and arranging a meeting with the one who might execute it, or a part of it, at least.
And where is this woman?
She awaits you in the Archive, Your Grace.
Thank you, Cyril. Shall we then?
Where the hell's the Archive? Hold on, I gotta go back in here, because there's somebody with a quest.
The bearer of the burning quill is within.
News has reached us of the black bulk that soars over the strait. Lord Cyril has ordered our survey teams to investigate it forthwith. It would seem that your battle is coming to a head, my lord. I pray that you and your brother will emerge victorious. May the Firebird's flame burn ever in your hearts, and guide you back home safely.
Lord Marquis, if you have a moment.
What is it, Cyril?
One of our brethren lately journeyed across the strait in order to pursue a new avenue of inquiry in our ongoing investigation. He sent an owl some while ago, but we have heard naught from him since.
Was he surveying another fallen ruin?
No. The object of his study was a savior cult that has arisen in Ash in recent years.
No, don't make me Ash!
We believe it may have some connection to the Circle of Malleus, an ancient religion that worshipped Ultima as its god. By gaining an understanding of this new faith, we hoped to learn more of the Circle's original beliefs.
And so you sent one of your brothers to Ash, a continent teeming with orcs and Akashic.
Fully cognizant of the risks, yes. I entrusted the mission to one of the most able of our order, the Third Chair, a master of the arts of combat and survival, both. Though he has been silent for some days now, I have thus far refrained from sending any others in search of him, lest they be lost in turn. Yet, it seemed only right to inform you of the situation, given your unique experience of the perils of Ash. For as you so earnestly advised me, it would not do to abandon a man to his fate, when he might yet be saved.
All right, now I gotta go back.
It would not. But Ash is a big place. Can you be any more specific?
Perhaps. The last owl I received from him mentioned a village where he had heard the cult were wont to assemble. Mickleberg was its name. It lies in the southern reaches of Walud. If aught ill befell him, I expect it did so there.
Right. I'll see what I can do.
You are much too kind, my lord. Go then, with my hopes. And may the Firebird's flame ever burn in your heart.
I should probably go and do this first, because he's probably going to want me to come not go to the hideaway, but come back to him.
When last I heard from him, the Third Chair was bound for Mickleberg. If you mean to seek him out, my lord, I can think of no better place to start.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Okay. Back to Ash we go, I guess. It's the place with the door that I couldn't go through. Wait. Not really sure which... I don't know what's closer. I guess... Oh, I don't think it really matters. So there's a village down here, huh? Uh-oh. The performance. Is this a restart the game moment? Iggy. Is it gonna catch up here, or am I gonna... This is why going back and forth between a bunch of places sucks ass, because this happens. And yeah, it's not recovering. Okay. That means I'm gonna have to do an emergency restart. Even though we're up to 40 minutes, I'm not gonna restart. I'm not gonna start a new episode. I'll just pause the recording quick. Whoops. And I will be back with you momentarily. Oh, and it looks like encoding has overloaded as well, so... Great. Alright, back at the edge of infinity. Game's running good now. Running well, rather. And it looks like OBS has caught up from its issue. Why is there an eyeball out here all of a sudden? Fuck. Well, it's dead now. More, huh? Oh my god, there's people here. And it's that music.
These people aren't turned. And the village seems safe enough at least.
Well, yeah, they locked their wooden door.
What is going on here?
Ah. Did you two... heed the call?
Heed the call? No, I came here looking for someone. To be honest, I wasn't sure I'd find him here. Let alone all of you.
Is that so?
What are you doing here? Is this where you live?
It is my home. The others, they heeded the call.
What you keep mean? Saying that. What do you mean?
They came here to perform the rite, just as King Barnabas instructed.
He's dead.
This village is their altar, where they shall cast their souls upon the gentle waters and give themselves to the Lord.
Give themselves?
Oh, Lord, cleanse us of our sins.
Let us be reborn in your loving arms.
Free us from the torment of this mortal realm.
They want to be saved. Forgive me. But did another foreigner, like me, come here? He was probably wearing a cowl.
You mean the traveler from Stone? Yes. He is staying at my house, toward the rear of the village.
Thank you. If you don't mind, I'll go and greet him.
They seek the same salvation Barnabas did.
Salvation.
At least the third chair still lives.
Well.
Let's go and find him.
Does he? Because he didn't exactly say he was alive.
My friend with the cowl has been staying with me. Please, make yourself at home too, traveler.
Can I, like, look around and loot the place? See, now that's what we gotta do, if there is any loot here. Oh, there is. Empty shard. As no one's ever thought to open that little chest before. Yeah, when you got music like this, you gotta stay on your toes. There's something more going on here than just people wanting to sacrifice themselves to their god. Oh, he is alive. Okay, I was expecting to find like his skinned body or something. The Chronicles of Mirkvar, being a collection of tales as recounted to his most exalted majesty, Lord Bjornhard of the Veldermark. Jesus. As you are no doubt aware, Lord Bjornhard, there was once a race of men who commanded the most forbidden and of forbidden magics. But did you ever hear tell of the executors, those charged with driving out these heretics? The order had its origins in the Crystalline Dominion, by whose ruler's decree it was tasked with the protection of mankind and sent forth to extinguish the forbidden magic wherever rumors of its use might arise. Having in due course succeeded in their mission and driven the utterers of the unutterable from the land, these secretive souls withdrew from the stage of history, never to be heard from again. Great, now my eyeballs are stained with white text lines.
Excuse me. Are you with the Undying?
Yes, he's wearing the outfit, dude.
I am. And so it would appear, are you? Lord Rosfield, if I am not mistaken. That's right. And you must be the third chair. I am. Cyril was worried for your safety. He sent me to find you. Then I must apologize. I did not mean to trouble the bearer of the burning quill, much less you, my Lord Marquis. He said that you had failed to report. Is there a reason for that? I came here to study the followers of this new faith. But the more I learned of them, the more my own faith began to falter. You have seen them at their prayers, have you not?
They're just faithful, dude.
They devote themselves to the veneration of their lord with a fervor I have never seen before. Praying night and day that they might be rid of their wicked wills and reborn in their savior's light. Not that they might be granted respite from their worldly woes, but so that they might continue to serve him. Serve him with all of their beings. I, too, swore to devote my life to the service of my lord and master, but this... 'tis different. It is more. And so I would see it through to the end. See these people safe, that they might achieve their dream. That they might do their duty to their lord. Even if it should keep me from doing my duty to mine. You do understand what their dream is, don't you? I do, my lord. They would cast aside their wills and become a Kashyyyk. I know that it may be hard to believe, but to these people, that is the very essence of salvation.
Well, hold on.
Forgive me, my lord. But I must remain here. If you are to return to Master Cyril, I would consider it a great...
What the hell?
Did you hear that, my lord? Something is happening. I'll go find out what. Stay here.
Well, I was gonna ask, like, if all they want is to be a Kashyyyk, how in the world are they not yet a Kashyyyk? The rest of Ash is, except the bearer people. Are they all bearers? Oh, they just disappeared. Oh no, it's an aether flood.
Aether flood. Oh no.
Yeah, I guess they got...
There must be something I can do.
Hold your breath, I guess. I don't know. Hey, this is what you guys wanted, isn't it?
Found her.
Ready, brother?
Dang, that fills up the limit break gauge like crazy. There's gonna be a bigger fish, because there's always a bigger fish.
What now?
Oh, jeez. Yeah, of course, it's a circle. I should have known it was an arena. What the hell? It's a fiery iron giant.
We meet again.
Or iron golem. I forgot what they're called. Iron giant. Titus. 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 Wrong game, I guess. Alright, we can play some games. Final Fantasy XIV. That wasn't so bad. Fallen iron. Oh, we win. Don't tell me there's more. What the hell? How'd that one get through?
Damn it.
What? Dude, come on. And now they're going all Akashic. I can see it.
Devoting themselves to the service of their Lord, just as I did when the Undying plucked me from the gutter and gave me a cause to believe in, a duty to serve was everything to me, and I would not deny them that fulfillment. Even if they must become Akashic in order to achieve it. Forgive me, my Lord Marquis. I did not mean to trouble you with this. My findings
Could you deliver them to Master Cyril for me?
Of course. Your duty will be done.
Look, my lord. They are saved.
It's not what I was expecting, to be honest. When they became Akashic, I thought we were going to have to cut them down, which would have been equally depressing. Okay, they brought me back here automatically. Well, that's good. We didn't have anything else to do in Walud right now.
They are saved. Founder. I should get this report to Cyril.
Yes, I shall. And then it's time to end this episode. The game is struggling again.
My Lord Marquis, welcome back. I am glad to see you hale and whole.
I met with your third chair, Cyril. He bade me deliver his findings to you.
Mickleburg Report, the Third Chair's report into the teachings of an Ashen Savior cult, its outer edges stained with the same man's lifeblood.
Thank you, my lord. He remained in Ash?
He died protecting the villagers from an echo. I buried him in Mickleburg. I'm sorry that I couldn't save him.
If you could not save him, no one could.
The villagers, they were believers in this savior cult. They prayed to their god that they might be unburdened of their wills. Then an ether flood came, and their wish was granted. Your brother sacrificed himself that they might live, even knowing that that life was death by another name.
Then he perished defending liberty. A hero's end. For the right to choose how one dies is no less sacred than the right to choose how one lives.
Sid would agree. He wanted to build a world where people could die on their own terms.
A noble ambition. To die for one's cause is the most perfect expression of one's faith. It matters not how misguided others might judge one's decision to be. Only that the decision is one's own. We live according to the teachings of our order. We believe in them. We protect them. And yes, we die for them. For better or worse, that is our creed.
But he didn't die for your creed. He died to save them. And you still believe that what he did was right?
I believe that he believed it was. We of the Undying are not slaves, but willing servants. And this was his will. The ultimate expression of it.
All right. I'd like to know this man's name, Cyril. To know the names of all the Undying who've fallen in the line of duty. They died serving my house. It's only right that I remember them. That is my duty.
Of course. I shall fetch the Book of Martyrs at once. My lord, it has been, and shall ever be, the greatest honor of my life to serve House Rosfield. Though our duties may differ, yours is no less important. I pray with all my heart for your success. And were they here, I have no doubt but that every one of my fallen brothers and sisters would feel the same.
Damn, that was worth a lot. Oh, wow. Clayhearth signboard, the emblem of the Undying's headquarters in Tabor, the village is home to the finest leather workers and lapidaries in Dalmechia, who are little aware that their affable new neighbors are members of a secret society sworn to serve the Phoenix, as well as some more come. Ah, jeez. The game is struggling.
Shall have the Book of Martyrs fetched from the requiratory forthwith, my lord. But prithee, do not let me keep you should you have more pressing matters to attend to. The volume will be waiting for you when you next return.
Well, when I next return will be next time on Let's Play Final Fantasy 16. Because it's time for this episode to end, and I obviously need to restart the game again anyways. So until then, goodbye.